Hi guys, and welcome to today's lesson. So we're carrying on with this ink drawing of a skull. So we started it in pencil, but we're going to be carrying it on in ink. And today we're going to be actually using ink. So I've got a couple of pens. I've got one really bold one, this Pigma, which is probably like a 5 mil, something like that, wide, very thick tip. This one's only a 0.5, so we'll probably be using this more and just using the Pigma for like little smaller sections. And I do actually, I've got a brush pen actually that I'll get as well. So this is a soft tip, so you can do kind of thin and thicker marks with that. I might actually start with that, having shown the other ones first. So basically, we're just going to be carrying on. First thing I'm going to be doing is kind of inking in over the pencil drawing. Then we'll be erasing the pencil once we've kind of got all the information transferred across. Probably that'll be mostly what we do today. And then we'll be kind of like doing another session where we go in and put like finer little hatch details later. So I'm going to start. And the whole process is still kind of like refining into what we're looking at. This brush maybe is still a little bit thicker than I was looking for, so I'm going to go back to the 0.5 that I was about to start with. So what I'm doing as I'm working is I'm trying to kind of always vary my line weight a little bit, so it doesn't have to stay completely the same the whole drawing. I'm not going too heavy with any kind of shading at the moment. I'm mostly just focused on just getting all the lining in. But there are little points like here I can probably say, well, that's going to go. These are going to be shaded in eventually. And I also want to try to keep maintaining a sort of a character to it as well. So my kind of lining is not too kind of procedural. I want it to have like a little bit of interesting character as I'm working. Also add little extra bits that are going to be coming in later. Double line things here and there, so I put a little bit of a double line. So not necessarily doing a fully connected line for places like this, where I might want to kind of soften the edge with my hatching, but anywhere where I've got like a crisp edge, like this kind of, this nose bone is overlapping. So we know that's going to be crisp, but down there it's going to be a little bit more textured. Here as well, can maybe just put some smaller lines in there. There's a lot of different ways you can hatch. Here I'm using quite short strokes to build up. The shadow inside this nose. And you can start to cross a little bit as well. Thank you. So let's complete this. Tip of the skull. And then start giving it, oh actually I've got a little bit here, I want to just get this shadow should be connecting down. This little bit here as well, so you don't want to miss out anything you did figure out. Not that you'll, obviously you can always put it back in, but all those bits we put in the pencil stage, we kind of want to try to maintain, just because they're going to help us map everything in probably. So also maybe some of these, just faintly put in some of these little gaps between the teeth. That's we've knocked back to a much cleaner version. So if I pop to the brush pen, I'm gonna put some of the really dark notes in. So I'm gonna like fill that little gap. So you can see as we get into those kind of lighter shadows, I'm being a lot more restrained than, say, on this right-hand side where we've got darker shadows, we can be a bit more bold with how dark I go straight away. And we are going to be building a lot more depth onto this right-hand side as well, which will kind of balance stuff out. But to begin with, I'm just working on this kind of internal section, which is probably where like the main kind of focal point of the piece is. And we're coming to a point almost at the end of today's session, so do a little bit of kind of hatching, softening out from some of these shadows that we've put in. So I'm doing that just with kind of like little dotted sort of textures coming off this edge. Some can sort of crosshatch a bit as well. Can maybe just run connection, because there is a connection all the way down that line of that shadow edge, which is nice to get in. Yeah, that's probably not a bad point to stop for today. Started to build some of the shading on the right-hand side of the skull here. Sorry, the central part of the skull, and then we'll be moving into the right-hand side and starting to build out those darker bits next session. So yeah, hopefully you guys have enjoyed the process today. As always, if you've got any questions, you can pop them into the comments below the video. If you want to stay up to date with more videos from myself and other tutors from the school, click the subscribe button. And you can click the link through in our profile if you want to see the sorts of paid qualifications that we offer, because we've got a bunch of those for anyone interested in sort of extending themselves further and getting more direct feedback from teachers. But yeah, we'll stop there for today, and I'll see you guys soon.